8 times. They're looking for number 9 as we get set for this one. The Denver Bulldogs, of course, in their traditional blue with the red trim and the white mountains on their bottoms. And, of course, Hollywood in their, or New York in their famous Hollywood jumpers of black and white. Well, I knew I was going to mess that up at some point as we get set to go. And for the opening of this match, the man, the voice, in his 13th season of the USAFL Nationals, we are almost set. We're still waiting for a couple of things to... gel here. Who are our umpires today?
Our umpires, Ross McLaren and B. Jay Hine. And the goal umpires are Jay Buckle and Jay Lichtet.
Yep. So those are the folks who are orange and the green, the spirit of the game, and here for the opening of this first half is the man, the voice, in his 13th Nationals, Grilla.
Smack down in the middle, up they rise above me, looking so lovely. It looks like it could have been New York to get away with it. They're looking for an outlaw on the outside. They want to take it out then at the outside, but they move it and groove it towards the wing. They've got a free man now. They leave the one, an amazing one under the forward line. Ball is free, running on the free ball, back of the pack, attacking on goal. New York, they want to be a part of it, but they hit the post for a minor score. A very quick sortie out of the bezel of the G-shot there, Brian, on the Blackbone scoreboard. New York move, like I said, to 1 point. Take it away, the man with USAFL.com.
It was a Wilbur post. Hello, Dominic Kennedy will put the ball back in the play, just at the edge of the square, up the right side, looking. They rise up high, down to the ground it goes, controlled by Denver. And there is a handball, and they're still going to control it. There's a left foot kick. It's a booming kick, straight in the middle of the ground. Couldn't hang on to it cleanly, but now they go, and they go after, and they chase it. Still controlled by the Bulldogs. We have a whistle, and it looks like it was tackling without the ball, I believe. Indeed, Grilla agrees, and so does no. Yeah, I'm sorry, it was prior opportunity in face of Grilla. So it almost looked like they had had it, they lost it, but in any event, it'll be a free kick to the New York Magpies. It'll go in short, looking for number 84 there, which was Andrew Davis, who came out and was uncontested. So Davis from just outside the 50, he's about 65. He goes to his right, he has to come off the mark, he does. Left foot in short, and he finds the number 20 there in Matthew Lovell. And Lovell will be from dead out in front. It'll be about a 50-meter kick. Mark is about 40 meters out. It'll be from straight to front. So here's Lovell. Up to 48, 47. And Matthew Lovell has hit a goal. 6 points to the New York Magpies as they extend their lead. And there it is on the Black Chrome scoreboard. In fact, there has been a thunder strike for them. 2 quick scores on the Black Chrome scoreboard. The Magpies 1-1-7. Denver Bulldogs yet to score. Grilla, pretty good start for the Magpies.
Yeah, pretty good start indeed. They're kicking with the breeze and they're taking full advantage of it very, very early. Breeze ebbs and flows, it whips up, and for the last couple of days it seems to get a bit stronger as the sun starts going down in the west. Anyways, back in the middle, toss up this time, Ruckmanu battle, leaping lizard in the air, or leaping magpie in the air, really took off, if you know what I mean. The Bulldogs, the dogs out the forward line, good mark to the number one. Number one, I think it's Ben, that's Casey Robertson. Robertson, looking right, looking left, now looking long. Indecision time now to kick left on the slant route. Lead doesn't connect on the bounce. Bootlegging around Denver. Shot on goal high. Transmission of Moses. Ball coming down quick. Almost a mark to a Bulldog down there in the kennel. That was number 7 for the Bulldogs. He couldn't quite hang on there. Harkness here. The angel sang. And they're singing across the boundary line out there. It's over and out for the boundary umpire, Brian Barrett.
Here we go from that boundary. From that boundary throw in Denver in a very advantageous position. Roughly, we'll call it 52.34 meters around from their target. As the ball comes spinning back into play, it's controlled by the Bulldogs. He just got it off left. However, there was prior opportunity. He was in the clutch.
Yep.
And he will get called for holding the ball in proper disposal. So free kick to the New York Magpies as they lead 7-0 on the Black Chrome scoreboard. Opening minutes of this game. New York won their first game over Dallas earlier today. And Denver lost to Orange County earlier today. So it's make or break time for the Doggies. They have been behind this before. They've made it to the final under these situations. Left foot kick out in the middle. Chasing it down is 21 for Denver, who is Scott Tuttle. And Tuttle was unable to handle it, but he does get it on. He gets it forward up in the back four. 17 and Tim Wilson Humphreys is there. And they play on, even though there was a whistle, there's a shot towards goal. It looked like it went off to the side. Or has it? It is, in fact, a goal. And Denver has answered. Back to a good 1 point. 6 points. Black Chrome scoreboard, it's back to a one-point game. A very torrid start for this one. 1-1-7 for the New York Magpies, and one straight six for the Denver Bulldogs. Ball back in the center as we continue here on an increasingly hot day deep in the heart of Texas here at Onion Creek Soccer Complex. And our thanks to the folks with the City of Austin, as well as the men and women in law enforcement who are out here doing their best and doing a fantastic job of keeping everybody safe. As the umpire is walking in, and he will throw the ball back up into play. And here we go again. And this one is not to the advantage of New York. There's a long kick. The pack four is marked nicely in defense. There's a handball off to the near side. Good job. They get it around the 26, who is Kennedy. Dominic Kennedy for Denver. And now they get it on nicely. It's a short kick. They'll go across the mound. That's probably not the best decision, but in fact, it does pay off. And they'll pick it up on the far side. The ball will find the boundary line out of bounds. 7-6 once again. New York on the Black Chrome scoreboard, Rilla.
Kennedy, like snake oil, has been around for a long, long, long time down there for Denver, and still a very athletic-looking man, and he's trying to lay down the fabric for the young Turks, the young Bulldogs who are running free out there. Kennedy, a very reliable fullback indeed. In and under the pack attack, like this thing called wrap in the middle. Umpire whistle on the play. Illegal contact too high, going the way of the Magpies. Chance to move forward. And ahead. Who were they to take in the forward line? One-on-one, you can see man-on-man coverage with one loose dropping back into the hole for Denver. That's the way they're going to play. Good kick, good loop, good mark. Lift up without a ladder and took it cleanly. Number 84 for the Magpies, who is Andrew Davis. Davis delivers delightfully through the hands of number 5, though. He wants to go back to the ball. Denver arrive on the scene. Tackled. Ball jars free. Another chance for the Magpies. Just on the play. But it's going the way of Denver to relieve the pressure, Brian.
Denver will have a chance to set KDS or sketch and see what they can have in front of them. So he'll go back and take a look here as no leads forthcoming. Everyone just sort of milling around like they're watching a baseball game. But in the event, oh, I'm a baseball fan, so it's that one. In any event, New York's still off the top. Get up on that far side. The Magpies are going to Magpie. Ball out of bounds, and we'll have a boundary throw. Again, if you're just joining us, 7-6 in favor of the New York Magpies on the Black Chrome scoreboard. We're just near sort of the halfway point of the first half. Still have a little bit to go. As the ball comes back into play, it pops up in the air. Again, pulled by Denver. New York still has it on that far side. We have a whistle, a tackle, and a free kick. Yeah, and it'll go to New York up on that far sideline. So now they'll look for it. They'll go high and up into the middle, settling under it. Almost like pretty much uncontested with Danica. And the old man goes out to the left side, and the mark is taken by 27, which is Ryan Cartwright. So here is Cartwright with a long one up the side as they continue up the corridor. Can't control it, all to the ground. Still picked up, and now they fist it forward, but New York is able to get to it. Everyone swarms upon them. We have a whistle, and it looks like, I thought maybe they were just going to call no prior opportunity, and in fact, it is a ball off thriller.
Nice. You know how this game attracts people from downtown bars? Well, it's attracted two more AFL players today. Joe Watson, the captain of Eston, is in the house.
Joe Watson?
Yeah.
Wow.
And we also have a Sydney Swans player whose name I'm going to keep under wraps until he gets here. So this game attracts everybody. We've got the captain of Eston in the house. Meanwhile, with the Bulldogs, with the number 6. They kick it down desperately down to the board line, but a good fist of fury, as we like to say, came from the Magpies. We're sure the ball crossed the line, but it was touched first, only a minor score. They conceded the 1 point. They were happy to do that. And we see on the scoreboard, it's 1 goal apiece.
1-1.
1-1. It's 7. All squared up here on Division 1 field. Real beer. fill up your solo cup for reason. Put your hands up there. There's a man on the mark. Katimba, ball kicked in. Good tackle from the ground level, dominating from below, if you will, was another 15 for the Bulldogs, who was in fact leading McMahon. And that's just the way it is. Ball up, not far from the center of the ground, Brian.
Denver trying to get something here as they were able to tie the game finally. Robertson with a short handball. He gets it forward, and it's gone at a nice mark. And back to the number 17, which again is Marcus Layton. Layton has played very well. He's been one of their stalwarts over the last couple of years. So he will set up. The kick will come. We'll call it 45 meters out. So here is Layton to put his team in the lead. It's a left-footed kick. Going through, everyone's happy, and so is the umpire. 6 points for the Bulldogs, and they're on top.
Scoreboard, Denver, slow out of gates, but rocking steady now. 2 goals, 1-13. Lead the New York Magpies, 1-1-7. Straight shooting sons of guns, Denver at the moment. The power of the moment is in the middle, right here, right now. Right here, right now. Tapped down by New York. They're trying to escape out of the middle, but not on the watch of the number 9 there of the Denver Bulldogs, who in fact is Micho McGrath. And he held him up like a roadblock up in a chicken. No convoy allowed through there. A lot of players around the ball. Up, up, and away we go. Fisted forward by the Magpies. Topped off with the pass by the number 24 there for Denver, who is Mesmer. Couldn't mesmerize him through the pass. And turned the ball over. The New York Magpie was tackled. He had prior opportunity. Deemed to be holding the ball. And the man has got the whole world in his hands. The number 15 there in the lead, McMahon, Brian Barrett.
Here's McMahon up. He goes on to his left foot, which is his right foot. It's long, it's small, and it doesn't drive anybody. It's pulled out of bounds. Back the ball has gone out of play. Broke down for throw in. If you're enjoying the coverage here, we'll have some games for you online a little bit later on, including the Denver Lady Bulldogs against Sacramento. That's coming up. I'll be headed over that one in just a moment. Meanwhile, I'll talk to men.
We were out of money here. The Triplets came to our emotional rescue, our financial rescue, and they have been with us ever since. Throw it out of sight, Brian. Give it to me, baby.
Here we go. As we continue play, as we move up on that far side, the ball again is in dispute. We have a whistle and we'll have a ball out because we need to double check the score after our delay here. It's 1-13 to Denver, 1-1-7 to New York. That's all on the Black Rose scoreboard. And thanks to the Black Rose and everyone else who made this tournament possible over the years. As New York is scuttling it forward, and we have that stopping football that we were seeing a little bit earlier. Scooter and I were talking about it a little bit earlier on today. You know, it's we've seen a lot of that, it seems like. I know both these teams prefer open and flowing football, so hopefully we'll get to see that. I know they're trying. They're not trying to tie it up, it seems like. Ball up on that far side and chased out of bounds by Ben Harling. For Denver, we'll have another ball in. Again, 13-7 on the Black Crimson scoreboard. Denver up by a straight kick draw.
This is the way Denver like it. They've got the lead. Now they're going to play man-o-man. You and me, baby, all day long over the next 20 minutes. So they've got a lead, which they think they can defend, Brian.
Yeah, they do, and they've had to defend leads like this on this stage before, and they'll be hard-pressed to do it now against such a talented team from New York. As the ball can spin back into play, and back to the ground, and everyone gets down, gets punted, throw a blanket over, 23 players, and we'll have another ball. Ryan Barrett alongside Grilla here in Division 1, Cooper's Field, New York, trying to punch themselves a chance to get in tomorrow. Denver trying to keep their dreams alive. We have a whistle out of all of that, and a free kick as they are whistling for the ball to come back. So we'll bring the ball back and we will do this again. New York, number 11, has the ball in his hands, and that is Brendan Noakes. So Noakes will go back He'll assess the situation. He'll do some statistical evaluation and then kick the ball up and almost take it off here with the ball. Andrew Davis, who has not contacted the ball at the 4-1, then he's able to clear it out up on that far side. It bounces through, up in the air, down it goes, and finally at number 40 for New York. He handballs it around. Good little give and go, and that's what New York does as they're able to do it, but Denver sniffs it out and reads it. Tackle dispossessed. And then it's whistled, and we have a ball up, as there was no prior opportunity for anything to happen there. So the spirit of this great game will be put back into the air one more time going.
Yeah, well, no zone coverage from Denver. Like I said, man-on-man football. So therefore, every contest is going to be a 50-50 arrangement. Who wants it more? Who's got the physicality? Here we go. Not a lot of space between them. They went down like a deck of cards, and Denver will come up with it. Could have been the Candyman. He offloads it towards the number 15 there for the Bulldogs, who in fact is McBond. Big back attack on the forward line. Ball free the other side. Picked up by Denver. Shot on goal. Bounces over the top, but through from minor score on the right-hand side. Sliding back to the Black Chrome scoreboard. They move to 14. New Denver. York Magpies in the coup are seven.
A very handy point for Denver, as it's now a two-kick game, as the Magpies fullback will put the ball back into play. He's going to go straight down the gut. He's going to kick it into the middle and see what happens. And Harkness was able to get his handle on it for Denver, but it's controlled by New York. He kicks with his left foot, which is his right foot, and it goes up for a mark, and he's taken it. A good rising mark there by the number 60, is Chris Georgiou, who takes the mark nicely. Georgiou will fumble it into the middle, will punt it into the middle, or something along those lines. And now move forward as they look out to the near side, going up and almost taking the mark and dragging his man out of the play. And the ball goes to ground, we'll have a whistle and a ball up as New York trying to push for that tying score, or at least to draw it close. It was 6 points, it's now 7. 14-7 on the Black Chrome scoreboard. The ball comes back in the air. Nobody got it off the ruck. And then it bounces around. New York still has it. It pops out of the back. We have a whistle. And it's going to be a free kick coming out the deck.
I think it could be Wilson Humphreys, another stalwart. Look at Banneker. Now, Banneker has time and space. Dangerous. Dangerous even, New York Banneker up the line. The Revolution player looking for the Candyman. Now, Banneker comes up on the secondary. Good cardio. New York now got a lot of work to do. Hustling, bustling at Denver Bulldogs, who let the dogs out. Let's get out of here, says the Magpie. We can't because of the pressure. Here comes Banneker again. Pressure like no man has known before. Happy to create the 50-50 situation. That's what I'm talking about with Denver. Old dogs for a hard road out there, Brian.
Indeed, and Andy Panica, who played his last game for the Revolution down in Florida, was cheered off a hero after the Revos beat up on Canada as the ball goes out of bounds. And we'll have another boundary throw, and again, the score on the Black Chrome scoreboard, 14 for Denver, 7 for New York, as we play midway through the first half. The ball comes spinning back in the play. It hits the ground. Again, everyone's sort of afraid to go up on it. And another whistle. The umpire will come in and adjudicate, and he says, give it to me, and we will ball it up again. On the wing position in front of the, the VIP side, we'll have a whole bunch of people over there watching the finals football tomorrow. Meanwhile, here is New York. Oh, that was a good turnover. Harkness was there. Harkness did a very good job of defending all season long. He steps in front of him and goes down, at least for his possession.
Yep, no spreads, no fancy football here, no spare men at the back of the tack, no wide receivers, just man on man all day long. And twice on Sundays tomorrow you get the feel from Denver if they get that far, far out to the other side, foot race, not a man on man contest. The number 10 you see in front of the pack there is Summers. Summers hot like the Texas sun in the face of the pack. A mountain of rocks out there on the mountain of Magpies. Mountain rock on up on those mountains, Denver. And the ruby on those rocks is picked out by the umpire and he sets it to the heavens. It's smacked down there by the number 15 for Denver. With his fist was McMahon. Gains valuable yardage for his side towards the boundary. Look at both Hail Mary kicked by the Magpies to the boundary. Bounces out on the full. Receiving the free kick could be Denver. and they will send it back into their offensive region, Brian.
George Scudamathis in the boundary umpire pretends it's an air point, goes, and we'll have a free kick on that far side. Marcus has been a beautiful ball hit listening in the Texas side. So here is Marcus, who puts the ball back into play up on that far side. The players rise, the ball doesn't, it hits the ground, Harley over there. He gets bumped off the play. He gets tackled by two Magpies. Denver wanted a call, maybe push the back to something. The umpire says, nope, we'll just give it to me. We'll ball it up. It'll be great. So here we go again. Denver, everything has sort of slowed down a little bit. We haven't had a point in some time. It's 14-7 on the Black Crown scoreboard. As the ball is on that far side, it's tackled.
Making the sting right out of a game, Denver. We have a half time here as yes, coming up pretty soon. Let's check that score. 2-2, Denver. 1-1, New York. Still anybody's game, but Denver are happy with proceedings. Still, they have to be worried. They need to still be on the tack. Still a little bit early to ice the match, if you will. Who's got the willpower? Who has the cardio power to go the distance after three matches of USAFL round-robin competition? You see it as a New York Magpie dropping back. And everywhere a New York Magpie goes, the Bulldog is his truck. And throwing out of sight. Half-time here at the football at this humdinger of a match. New York, the defending champions, two times champions of Division 1 versus the Denver Bulldogs, who are eight-time champions, looking to get their hands on the silverware once again. Again, we'll look at the Black Chrome scoreboard. 2-2 the Denver Bulldogs to 1-1 New York. That's just the way it is, Brian Barry.